character in one of my favorite movies, Madagascar. If you ever watched.
Who is that? Motomoto.
Motomoto. Cheers. You got it.
You know where Motomoto is, baby? You see, like, Cincinnati, white people like Fiona and...
Fritz.
And Fritz.
Yeah.
Motomoto. Oh, boy.
Yep. Big and chunky.
Motomoto. Hey.
Big and chunky, is that what it is?
That's a song.
Motomoto.
And so that's why the binomial domes are connected. Not because of language, but specifically across language.
You look like you have a collection of like... You're almost Indian or Cherokee.
I'll take that.
No, but it's the Congolese version.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you don't see these anymore, you know?
No, nowhere.
You don't. It's time. This tells a story of time.
Hey, you know what?
Yes.
We're here to tell time.
Yes.
You see, the rotation of that wheel tells time.
There we go. Yep.
You know?
It's right here. It's written all over.
You can see it.
The movement.
Movement. You don't know how it's really gonna turn out. I'm just gonna put that again. So I'm gonna try start with the blue. Right there. Put a little highlights at the bottom. I can actually press it on it. Do a nice clean layer of blue. Thicker layer, because the glazes just really like work as layers until I can get rid of all that on it, because you know I'm still experimenting. So I can even use it like that. Have that. And I can go back at the bottom here to just finish all that I had on that brush. Because it's still gonna take it. And then take a much lighter color. Looks like a pink. Let's see, can get this different color with it. Take it on the lower side. Now I can turn it upside down. so I can get the ring. And probably inside, I don't know if it's gonna make it. That's good. Same blue at the bottom, put it on the top. But yeah, a lot of people in America, and this is unlike Africa, in America a lot of people want to have presents. And when you have like pieces of this that are very sentimental, they really work well as somebody wants to give you an artwork when it's gifting you, because it's something that you really want to keep it in the rest of your life.
Right.
I got this in a Christmas or whatever 2023 from Kumba or from Kip or from whoever that is, and it's something that somebody will keep it on top of their desk or on the table for a very long time. Even if they're going to take it down sometime, they'll still keep it. And you want your friends to experience the same thing as you experience. So you buy them the pieces that you want them to experience, that piece, or the majesty of that piece, or the essence of the artwork itself. So I like that. I don't know how it's gonna turn out after the firing, but I'm sure it's gonna be beautiful. Because once it's from the fire, you have to comply with what the fire decides. And most of the times the fire makes good work. If they don't explode in the kiln, most of the time they have good, I mean, you don't know what it's gonna turn out to be. Because right now you can see I've already mixed a couple colors in it, different glazes, but you don't know what it's gonna turn out to be.
And I think for me, I'm most excited about the fact that it's a piece that's easy to own for somebody that wants
yes.
to own one of the pieces.
Exactly,
it's a
gateway to the real art. Well, it's so much of the real art, but it is the gateway to the what is not. So, you know, if it's a painting, you've already gone through a canvas, a paint, you've gone through like the framing, but with this, it's 3 minutes of throwing it, let it dry, which is drying bulk, and 3 minutes of glazing, which is with bulk, you know, and then it cuts the cost of production. So you can have this at a cheaper price than having a painting that I spent like 3-4 days or even a week or two working on a painting. And I'm not gonna give it up for $100. But for this one, I can give it out for less than $100 because I know I can make it immediately. I can replicate that. But with the painting or the sculpture, I cannot. So the prices go higher depending on the time and energy you put into it. But the time and energy I put into this is a little bit lower, but there's so much satisfaction and love that comes from this than even in the painting or the sculpture. So this is so sentimental. People want to put flowers in this. So if someone wants to put a flower in this, and he wants to do it like, let's say once a week, it's more sentimental than the sculpture that is out there, you know, like, or the painting that is on the wall. This is more practical and more livable. the art lives in the ceramic, because you're not going to throw away the ceramic, you'll throw away the flowers. This is going to be there forever, but the flowers will change every time. So this one is a symbol of change, a symbol of the practice of, you know what, me myself, I went outside to find flowers to put. Gives me another culture of just going to find the flowers. I want beautiful flowers, and the next time I want a beautiful vase for my flowers. And so everything changes with the perspective of what you really want. And I think this is what's up.
And if somebody wanted, you know, a piece, a vase, how do they, you know, get one of the vases? Pieces.
Here in the studio, mostly, and probably on my website, tiptoetarus.com. You find there, you can cart, check on the cart, how much, see that, bam. I think the technology right now is fascinating, that everything can happen at once. And I love that.
And you can ship them?
Yeah, absolutely. Once you pay.
Where? Only in Lexington?
Anywhere in the whole wide world. Anywhere. If you pay for the shipping, it's going to get to you. If you have an address, I ship it. See how that turns out.